All right, I'm in a Hyundai Sonata. It looks like an older one. Oh yes, a 2018. To win the most for you. Oh, stop blowing me. It's also about compassion, care, and justice. Sweet James brings over 500 trials of experience. Freaking Sweet James ad. And that's why they quit trying to connect to a phone. Quit trying to connect to a phone. Sweet James at 809 million. They can't guarantee the outcome, but you want. I can do a whole lot worse than Imagine Dragons. That'll work. Oh, passenger mirrors flipped out. Hey. Out the one next to me too. So it's 4:47 p.m. and I just had a pretty good conversation with the guy who is in the detail shop, which is impressive considering how little English he speaks. But he finally gave me what I needed. I've been trying to get for a while, which is an explanation as to what the cars are that are facing north between the detail staging area and the kickouts, which are all facing south. And yeah, he said they're cleans. That some of the car washers, when they're going to get one from kickout, they'll drive a clean one and park it there rather than put it where the cleans regularly go in the uptown area and then, you know, walk all the way to the kickouts. So, which means that I can use these to go up and not have to walk nearly as far to get a vehicle going up. So that's a good thing. I saw a handful of Hertz managers and I was going to ask them what was up with it. Now I'm realizing they probably wouldn't have even known. It's beneath them. But yeah, they're having a bit of a meeting of the minds next to the car wash. I'd love to know who the young black woman was in that group, because she was freaking gorgeous. So it was really warm when I got in. It was really warm when I got in here, but it's getting really overcast. It's looking like it might rain tonight. So I'm hoping. I've got my hoodie that I usually keep for working at HelloFresh inside the back of my car, because I got a feeling I might need it tonight. Speaking of HelloFresh, a little bit ago, I was still working with Keontae, in fact. He's gone for the night. He bailed out about 4:15. Winolo offered some more shifts at Factor. And Priscilla gave me clarification on when the house party is. It's Friday, as in the day after tomorrow. I was thinking it was Black Friday, but I wasn't sure. I don't know. They made it sound like it was a Thanksgiving thing. And to me, a Thanksgiving thing needs to kind of be adjacent to Thanksgiving. A week before Thanksgiving just doesn't qualify as a Thanksgiving party to me, but not my party, not my choice. They just asked me to bring my karaoke shit, and it seemed like a great idea. And I don't know if I'll get any money out of it, but it'll certainly help spread the word of what I do with karaoke and could lead to more gigs. Anyway, once I got the clarification from her to make sure that it's this, you know, 2 days from now and not a week and 2 days from now, I was able to jump on and get a Saturday night shift for Factor. The pay is notably better than the last two shifts I did for Factor. It's going to be the same $171 that I got back when I was working for doing all those production shifts at HelloFresh. I didn't see anything saying that it was sanitation, so I got a feeling it's going to be food production. In fact, all the descriptions, the job description was different. While it didn't specify food production, it did say that I would be working in cold storage. So, looking forward to that. Looking forward to being back at Factor. I like it there. I wouldn't want a full-time job there. It's not the sort of thing I would want to do full-time. Also, it's way too damn far. But, yeah, looking forward to that. And more money, of course. 4:56 p.m., and I did not have to walk far from Flip Lane to find a maintenance car, this one an F-stop. So, needing its PMs in the returns. Right near the door to the elevators, in fact. And this is blowing on me more than I like. It needs to stop. Not sure exactly what this is. Some kind of a Ford SUV, like a mid-size SUV. I'm thinking it might be an older Explorer. So, not to be confused with the newer Explorers that have the recall. But it's got a Sony stereo in it with a compact disc slot. I've used this particular stereo before, but it's always a little awkward.
Obviously, with the front sidewalk and step, so we didn't worry
about
any
KTAR on. That'll work.
You know, you're concerned about that after rain. And then when it did dry, it didn't spot, it didn't stain. It was just like it had been done yesterday.
On HD radio.
To choose from. Four times stronger than epoxy and a 15-year warranty.
It's one thing that my wife commented on was how...
Preset 2, 93.5. Well, that's not good. Let's see if I can get it on 94.5. HD2. How'd you hear that? That was a switch to HD radio. It had an HD radio logo that was grayed out, and then it went to the orange and white official colors of the HD radio logo. God, I wish I was doing this with the glasses. Coming down the ramp, I could see somebody stop on the return ramp in a really precarious place. I see that more often than I'd like. Let's see how I switch it to HD2. Well, first attempt worked. I tapped the HD radio logo on the touchscreen, and here it is. KWSS HD. Ha! Put it in preset number 2. Which preset number 2 went to static when I touched it. I like to leave my mark on these cars, whether it's a clock that's set correctly or KWSS HD on the tuner preset, or just less tuner presets that go to static. No orange hats in the middle spot, and I know this. I've got a Tesla at the front of my gatekeeper line, and I have no idea what the issue is. It's got the little grid where they write the problem in and the date and the initials of who did it, which I don't use that format. And I think I've explained why. And it kind of looks like somebody scratched out what the problem was and left the rest of the grid, which is confusing for me, because A, why'd you leave the rest of the grid? And B, if you wanted to go to the kickouts, why didn't you pop the trunk? I'm just letting it sit in the gatekeeper for a while. It's a good a place for it as any. 459. Probably a good time. They do have cars in front of me in the PM line, also the tire line. But now is probably the best time for me to keep bringing cars down as quick as I can, while the shop is still working. Man, I just heard a new song from AJR on the radio, but I didn't catch what the name of the song was. I liked it, though. It's on Alt Nation, and I'm driving a vertical screen Ford, and I've never really got a grip on how to work those kinds of screens. I need headlights on. No, they're on. It's just dark up here. Actually, no, they're on. I just had an odd brief encounter with my car. So I just took a car up from the, actually I did a maneuver I've never done before, which kind of felt like wasting time, but I feel legit in having done it. So now that I know what that clean car area is between the kickouts and the, I just realized I have my hazard lights on, and I shouldn't have them on. And I definitely do not have dash lights on. It's not that I can see. I wonder if the brightness is down low. No, that ain't it. I can't read the But I can't read the speedometer to save my life right now. Yeah, I'm going to pull over because that's really bugging me. Make sure I park with enough space. If somebody needs to pass me, they can. It's on auto. This is weird. Wow, I'm wondering if maybe the bulb is burned out. So this actually has a real speedometer as opposed to a digital screen, a fake one. It has digital screens on each side that seem to be working just fine. Although they're a little dimmer than I like them to be. This one, f-stop. Well, I'm going to go ahead and put it, it's f-stop, I'm going to go ahead and put it with the rest of the stuff for PM, so I think we'll make a note about that, because there is a possibility, it's not fully dark yet, but I believe the sun is over the horizon. It's so overcast, it's hard to tell for certain, but I think the sun is over the horizon. It's definitely dim enough that headlights should be on, and I know my headlights are on, I have it in the auto setting. Well, I don't know if there's some kind of light sensor, and the car believes that it's bright enough that it doesn't need backlighting in the dash, but I absolutely can't read the speedometer. And I know it seems funny that I worry about shit like this, but you know what? Somebody needs to. Most everybody else just ignores this kind of shit, and I know it matters to the people that rent the cars, you know? It's not just me. Now there's definitely buttons here, and I leaned in close to see, and they're marked as brightness. Turning it up and down doesn't seem to be changing the brightness of the little screens beside. It's got that feature where it shuts off the engine if I stop and then restarts it when I go to move. I still got no orange hats here. Should move some there later. I keep stopping there and forgetting I ain't got no orange hats in the middle spot. Or is it this button? Aha! Huh? No, no, I was trying to figure out, somebody took the brightness on the dash and put it at the absolute minimum setting. I'm trying to figure out, does this thing have no dashboard lights? Or, I finally figured out how to work the damn
thing. Oh, I just spent the longest time I've ever spent in a Hertz rental car looking for the damn key. I found it. For some reason it was stuck up inside, above the driver's side sun visor, sitting on the little plastic piece that slides aside for the little makeup mirror. Got three newbies to my right with an up-down crew. Waiting for somebody to come scoop them up. A few women in that group. I'm up by the office, the gold members office. There's an SUV here with the back end popped. I don't see anything written. I need to pull over and look at it a little more closely. I don't see anything written on the windows, but let me check it out, because I don't know when I'll be back up by here again. And if it's something I need to come back for, I need to know that. Hard to say what the deal is with that. My procedure on cars like that, that are in this area, that have the trunk pop with no writing on them, is I just leave them there. This one, on the other hand, said, had a date on it, today's date, the 15th. It was, do not move, no key. There goes Jesse, he just picked those girls up. As a general rule, when I see no key, I check it anyway. Sometimes I find the keys. My headlights are off. Whoops. I mean, I'm in the garage. It's well lit. But I still like to have my headlights on after dark. Somebody walking near me. Wow, we got cars getting stockpiled in odd places here tonight. So yeah, I get them anytime I see this. It says no key, just to double check. They didn't have the wiper flipped up on this. So verify there's no key in it, flip up the wiper. Call it good, move on to the next task. But the first thing I do when I go in and checking to find a key is, if it's something that uses a proximity key, I hit the power button on the car. If it starts right up, the key's in the car somewhere. I just gotta find it. God, did it take me a long time to find it on this one. Now, as creatively as that was hidden, it's possible a manager hit that key there, planning to come get the car, but eh. He didn't want the car moved, should have kept the key in his pocket. I'm doing my job. Oh, except I'm kind of going in the wrong direction. Now, the fact that this says do not rent and no key, the fact it's in yellow and the way it's written, I'm assuming it's probably AR. There's one thing that generally doesn't get written down correctly on the windows, it's AR. Also known as on rent. So, especially coming from the area I found this in. So. Putting it in this line and then finding something else to take back up. I've seen people duck when they go under overpasses. That shit's funny. This is actually the record that's sitting on my turntable in my bedroom right now. That's all off Genesis self-titled. I think that came out in 84, 85, somewhere in there. 85, I think. It's got Mama on it, Second Home by the Sea. Such a good record. Alright, so I'm in some kind of a SUV crossover thing from BMW. Really nice, but it's also got over 50,000 miles on it, so I don't think it qualifies for Ultimate. It might. I really don't know. So, yeah, go into the flip ramp with this. Now, it just occurred to me, as I put that last one into the AR line, and I wrote AR and a question mark on it, and scraped off where it said no key, that the problem may as well have been no key in air quotes, because the renter got in it and absolutely couldn't find the key and drove it to the office to exchange it for something else. Which makes you wonder, is there anyone dumb enough to not realize that if you push the button and it starts, it's not a situation of no key, it's there, you just gotta find it. Anyway, I marked an AR and question mark. Taking to that line. We have an abundance of cars right now, so not putting anyone out by having it just sit there until somebody decides to start working on the AR cars. Alright. Squeezing this into a front spot in the flip lane. I'm having a really good day today. Just thought I'd throw that out there. 5:55 p.m. So I didn't have to walk far from the flip ramp to find a car kind of sitting off by itself with a G-stop on it. I think it says retail on it as well. And yeah, it's going to the retail department. That is the department where they get them ready to be sold as opposed to rented. Well, it's kind of a Hyundai midsize SUV. I'm guessing probably a Santa Fe or a Tucson. It's warm in here. Oh, that's too much crosswind for me. It's got 62,000 miles on it. Somebody's decided that means this one goes up for sale. I'm not sure what year it is. It honestly looks like it's this year's model, though. Maybe last year's model. I'm going to check that when I get over to where I'm stopping it in retail. We haven't had as many cars over in retail lately as we normally do. In fact, I think one day it was down about 3 or something ridiculously low. Part of me wants to really get to know the people at retail, see if I can work myself like a really good deal on a car. And then part of me realizes the last thing I need to be thinking about right now is buying a new car. My only car goal at this point, before everything else, is getting the Saturn insured. Everything else car related just takes a backseat to that. With the exception of trying to sell my junk cars that I don't want to keep anymore as junk cars, which mostly probably going to go to Rob anyway. And we're here. I was going to check the year of this, wasn't I? It's a 2019 Tucson. So not quite as new as I thought it was, but still fairly recent. I wouldn't want one of these. I'm just not into SUVs. Well, I'm on a roll right now with the luxury SUV crossover things. It's a Cadillac SUV crossover thing. Definitely not a contender for Ultimate, as I saw it said gold okay on the tag. And 22,000 miles, but if it says gold okay on it, it's definitely not anything that's worthy of putting in Ultimate. Come on, give me some tunes, car. No device found. Took me a moment to remember where the volume knob is on these little Cadillacs. Bon Jovi on Channel 25, Classic Rewind. I love this song when this one came out. I think this was the lead singer off of New Jersey, if memory serves. So back to the flip ramp with this thing. As tempting as it is to put it over in gold. Some genius parked a Chevy Malibu in the flip ramp, and it's hanging out so far in the back that it's into the pedestrian walkway. That's not cool. That and put it here because I'm seeing that as a safety hazard. . 1808, that is not a time. 608, that's a time. So I end up moving two cars into flip lane.
There's one that just had a whole bunch of space I could move it up forward into. And that maybe, that gave me a nice, easy space to get that Malibu out of the way. That thing was definitely a safety issue. Well, somebody's emptying the flip ramp actively right now. They already got that Cadillac SUV thing gone that I just barely drove up. So regarding how far they are in the back in the flip lane, when I first started working night shift, the angry elf told me not to have them behind the pillars. And I will regularly park them behind the pillars, but I never let them extend into the marked pedestrian walkway. So when they're there, that's when I take issue with it. Got four cars sitting in my maintenance line. As I said, this one here came out of, just out of the returns, very close to the little office on the return side. One of the gals that I really, really like is working. I saw her there. Didn't get a chance to say hi to her. She seemed like she's kind of occupied. I was busy getting this car out of there, but I expect that sometime tonight I'll get to chat with her. Every now and then her and I have interesting talks about our kids. Her son. A little older than Lily, a little younger than Allison. They're definitely working on replacing the bulbs and the lights out here on the lot. And I think there's some lights that are lit up now that have been off for a while. See one blue light on the maintenance yard chargers. Oh, I don't know if I mentioned that the other day. Yesterday. When I got here, I moved one car off the chargers. It was a maintenance car, and I was feeling pretty excited about it. I'm like, wow, somebody else realized what I'm doing with the maintenance electrics that have low batteries at night and moved the rest off. Yeah, wrong. There were four other ones. Some fool took the hats off them. I don't know what's up with that. I'm glad I caught it, though. On that note, I'm definitely not putting any cars over there like that on a day that I'm not working the next day.